Radhe Radhe Govinda Govinda Radhe Govinda Radhe Jaya Gopala Radhe 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 Govinda Govinda Radhe 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 Govinda Govinda Radhe Govinda Radhe Jaya Gopala Radhe Govinda Radhe Jaya Gopala Radhe Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram 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 Hare 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 Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram 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 Hare 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 Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Thank you.
Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Radhe Radhe Govinda, Govinda Radhe. Radhe Radhe Govinda, Govinda Radhe. Radhe Radhe Govinda.
Your leisure time in connection with our publications. So, you should arrange any time. Agyanitimirandhasya ज्ञानंजन शलाखया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो महावदन्नाय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गौरतिशे नमः। गुरवे गौरचंद्राय आधिकायै कदालये कृष्णाय कृष्ण भक्ताय तदभक्ताय भक्त्याभिहीनाय अपराधलक्ष्य क्षिप्ताश्च कामादितरङ्गमध्ये कृपामयीं त्वां शरणं प्रपन्ना वृन्दे नमस्ते चरणारविन्दं वृन्दे नमस्ते चरणं यं प्रव्रजन्तमनुपेतमपेतकृत्यं द्वैपायनो विरहकातरया जुहाव पुत्रेति तन्मयतया तर्वोभिनेदु तं सर्वभूतहृदयं मुनिमानतोऽस्मि तवैवास्मि तवैवास्मि न जीवामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञाय राधे तं नय माम चरणान्तिके। We are discussing something. What is pure bhakti in our morning classes? From the book of Srimad Bhakti Vinod Thakur, Bhakti Tattva Vivek, though is like a very booklet, very powerful. All doubts will go and we will know what is pure bhakti. And then we can engage ourselves in endeavoring pure bhakti. Then there will be no chance to fall down for bhakti. Then continuously will go develop our Krishna brain. I think in this modern days, after Sad Goswami, up to Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, only Bhakti Vinod Thakur is so very powerful. Acharya in this world. And that is why he is called Bhagiratha, who brought Bhagirathi Ganges in the shape of the same flow of Bhakti river from Rupa Goswami. That is why he is called Seventh Goswami. So it is so easy to read. All the books of Jiva Goswami and all others are in Sanskrit and so rich language, and some philosophical terms are there. It is very hard to know something from them. But from the books of Bhakti Vinod Thakur, the essence of all the Goswamis are in the books of Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur. Especially in Jaiva Dharma. Jaiva Dharma is the last book of Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur. So he has taken all the essence in a very little pot. Whole ocean of bhakti has been given in very little pot. He has tried. and it is not so very hard to go through them. So I think that it will be proper for you all that if you want to realize the writings of your Prabhupada, Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj, and Jiva Goswami and all others, first we should try to go through Jaiva Dharma. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur has translated and he has explanations, Bhashya, of all the books of Goswamis.
Commentaries.
Of all. So when I joined Math, Guru Maharaj, my kindly suggested me to read first Jaiva Dharma. Now what I am telling, only by the mercy of Bhaktivinoda Thakur through Jaiva Dharma. And then I read Srimad Bhagavatam, Shat Sandarbha, all the books, Govinda Bhashya, and all the books of all Goswamis. So, very easy, the books of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur. So in morning classes, I will try to give some essence of the literatures and all kinds of established truth in morning class. The process. He has explained two kinds of process. One, taking and other, giving up. Those who are favorable, we should accept. And those who are unfavorable,
we should give up.
So in the teachings of Upadeshamritam by Rupa Goswami, first he has told that what are unfavorable, they should be given. And what is favorable, we should accept all these things. Now I am coming in the sweet pastimes of Krishna. I think that these are more powerful. More powerful. If anyone has pure Shraddha, transcendental faith, and with that faith, anyone is hearing so with so honor and so strong belief these Harikatha. For from a powerful devotee who is Niragi Bhakta. From Niragi Bhakta. There are two kinds of Bhakta. Bhakta means
speakers.
Niragi and Saragi. Saragi is those who have some worldly desires to fulfill, some attachment in world. And by Harikatha they want to test out these things. They are Saragi. If anyone hearing their Harikatha, momentarily there will come something. But it will not be steady. It will go away. But those who are Niragi, having no attraction to worldly desires, to taste all these things, and having some realization, and he is perfect in all Shastra, Prabrahmani Nishna, and Prabrahma, and also in Sapta Brahma. Sapta Brahma is Srimad Bhagavat itself. And Parabrahma always engaging himself, observing himself in chanting, remembering, thinking, like this. Then he is Nirag Bhakta. Like Sukadeva Goswami, Parikshit Maharaj, like Gadadhar Pandit, like others, Bhakti Vinod Thakur. They are Nirag Bhakta. Then there will be no chance of falling down. Never. So, Harikatha will come through our ears, pure ears. And it will be in the shape of Krishna Himself. And then he will clear our heart. And he will make himself a seat, very good seat there. And then we will realize something. So, before beginning our Srimad Bhagavatam, sweet Harikatha, we will have to do prayer to Srila Sukadeva Goswami. Yang prabrajan tamanupetam apetakrityam dvaipayano pirahakatara ajuhava putreti tan maya tarvobhinedu tang
vyasya munimana
dvasya. Once all the pure rishis and muni assembled in Naimisharanya. Kali was coming. Krishna has left this world with his all associates in Braja, Dwarka and all. So all Kali was coming. So all were very fearful. What to do now? Time will come very hard. What should we do? And in the meantime, Sut Goswami came there and he became Vyas to tell Harikatha. Shaunak and about 88,000 of rishis, muni, all were assembled there. And they asked, especially for the human beings in Kali, this Yuga, when all will quarrel among for worldly things, so many wars will go away. The human being, even male and female, will give up their religion, anything. All will be engaged in worldly matters, mating and all other things. How should we do? What we should do? Kaise hamara kalyan hoga shreya? You should tell me how we will be
benefited.
Then he did this pranam and began Srimad Bhagavatam. Yang prabrajantam anupetam apeta krityam. I am doing namaskar to my Gurudev, to Srila Sukadeva Goswami, who is all pervading. Pervading?
Yes.
He is in atoms everywhere. Because Krishna is there, Srimati Radhika, conjugal sar, everywhere, on all atoms, trees and creepers, even human body, everywhere they are. There is no place where they are not. So to serve there, this conjugal, all the bona fide gurus are there. All bona fide gurus. In Baladev or Nityananda, always they are. Krishna without Baladev Prabhu never exists anywhere. So our Guru must be there. So Sut Goswami is telling that my Gurudev is all pervading, everywhere, serving his conjugals. So don't see that our Gurudev is dead. He never dies. If he is bona fide guru, never dies, no question. So he is doing pranam, that you are everywhere, inspiring Krishna bhakti in all. I know that when you took birth, no ceremony was there, not cutting off their. No jat karma was there. What is jat karma?
It is known as purification process after
What? Cutting the umbilical cord.
Yeah, and clearing and taking bath and all these things. And all these things, there was no ceremony. And at once he quickly left that place. And then his father Vyas began to cry, "Oh son, where you are going? Oh son, oh son." And all the trees in Oko replied, "Oh, who is son? Who is father? Who is mother? Who is son? Who is sister?" Only mohe vahi karanam. Only
attachment
is the cause, the root of all these things. Why you are calling like so? So trees are replying in echo. Who is this Sukhdev Goswami? Who is telling so sweet? Even Narada is present there. Even Vyasadeva is there, Parashar is there, all are there in the council of Parikshit Maharaj, but all requested Sukadeva Goswami, who was naked. Why they told? So we should know that who are Sukadeva Goswami. He was the parrot of Srimati Radhika. Srimati Radhika always used to keep this parrot with her everywhere. She has a golden case, sometimes out of case, sometimes in case, and sweetly carousing. Carousing. And he used to tell, "Oh, you should repeat me. Krishna, 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 Krishna." And the parrot in the same voice, so sweet voice of Srimati Radhika, don't totally follow anyone. If you, in our village, there was a person who kept a parrot. And sometimes he used to go to his house, home. "Oh, kaun hai? Kaun hai? Who are you? Who are you? Stop it. Nonsense, nonsense. Go away, go away, go away." Sometimes. Then we used to say, "Oh, who is staying?" And in the voice of his master. "Oh, he is anywhere hidden and telling like this." But after some time, "Oh, you knew that. This parrot is telling." And somewhere these parrots like Ram, 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 Radha, Krishna, telling like this, in a very sweet voice. It depends on the master who teaches them. So this parrot was with Srimati and she was giving him her
pomegranate seeds,
reddish, like pearls. And sometimes he used to give milk and very long rice, basmati chawal, very sweet, very twist. And he used to take and to follow Srimati Radhika, Krishna, Krishna, in same sweet voice of Radhika. Anyone cannot distinguish whether Srimati Radhika is telling, uttering, or he is uttering. One day she was doing so, and he was repeating Krishna, Krishna. But he flew from the palms of Srimati Radhika, very nearer Nandagaon, both each other.
Next to each other.
Only there is difference of two fingers. The border of Nandagaon and border of
Barsana.
Plenty of, so much kadamba trees in Nandagaon, and plenty of
Tamal
Krishna in
Tamal in Nandagaon.
No.
Barsana.
Tamal in Barsana. And some
kadamba
trees there. But it may be some tamal trees in Nandagaon and some be
Barsana
kadamba, but very little. We have seen in Nandagaon about thousand and thousand of Kadambatri, Kadambakhandi there. Kadambatera also, where?
Nandagaon.
Kadambatera, where Krishna used to take his flute and climb on the top of that tree and used to tell, oh, Shyamali, Gauri, Kalindi, calling all the gauls, and sometimes in the midnight, oh Radhike, oh Lalite, oh Vishakhe, oh, like this calling. This is called Kadamba
Te.
So everywhere, still now, but so many have expired in the separation of Krishna and Radhika. So that parrot came in Nandagaon and sat on the branches of any tree, tamal tree, because they like tamal tree, because Srimati Radhika likes tamal tree. And the color of both are like same, and began to speak, utter Krishna, 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 Krishna. And Madhumangal was at that time play with Krishna. So Krishna when heard that, oh, from where Radhika came? And he began to search Radhika, where is Radhika? And calling me Krishna, Krishna. But he could not see. Then he saw on the tree branch that, oh, very beautiful parrot with reddish
nose.
Big. Very beautiful. And he saw. Then he began to utter, Krishna, Krishna. And after some moment he began to tell, I'm so unworthy. So unworthy. And akritagya.
Ungrateful.
By nature, because we are birds. I was sitting on the palm of Srimati Radhika, always curiosity being, giving
pomegranate seeds
and sweet rices, and so much loving, always. But I'm so ungrateful creature that I left Srimati Radhika. And coming here, fie on me, fie on. Then Krishna saw that, oh, she's he's so much lamenting. That, come on, in sweet voice, my dear parrot, come on, come on, come on. And seeing this, he at once came on the hands, palms of Krishna. He began to crush Kirishyatka.
Yes.
And tell that, oh, so please tell what you are uttering. Then she began to talk, oh, Krishna, Krishna, I'm so ungrateful creature. I'm so
I'm very low.
Mane?
Low creature.
And ungrateful. I was playing on the palms of Srimati Radhika and she was so much giving me so much honor, so many sweet things, and I have left her and I have come to here. So fie on me, fie. Hearing this shlok, Kavi Karnapur has written that shlok, very beautiful. And he began to weep, that parrot. Krishna told that, oh, you have come to me. And you should repeat this time to me. I want to play with you. I want to also give rice and sweet and pomegranate.
Anardana.
And you should be with me. When they were telling and doing, loving that parrot, at once two sakhis came, Lalita and Vishakha. They were so much worried for that parrot. They went to Krishna and told, Oh, my dear Kanhaiya. This parrot is of Radhika, Shuk. Its name is like Bichakshan.
Daksha Bichakshan.
Bichakshan. And he is very sweet to Radhika. This parrot is life and soul of Radhika. If you are taking this and keeping with you, she may die. So please at once give this parrot. We will take it and give. She is so for this. He told, Krishna replied that if it is your sukh and your Srimati's sukh, then you can call. And if he is going easily to you, you can take it at once. They tried so much that, oh parrot, come on, come on. Srimati is calling you. But he was very peaceful in the hands of Krishna. And sometimes calling Krishna, Krishna. Krishna that told that, it seems that this parrot is not your Srimati ji, it is mine. So you can call and if he is going, no harm. But I will not give you. In any case, he may go. They tried hard but failed. They entered in the council of Srimati Yashoda Devi and told, oh mother, Yashoda, and they did pranam. Yashoda told that, oh, you seem very worried. Why you are so worried? They began to tell all the history that the parrot of Srimati Radhika has come here twice, and it is playing with Krishna is playing with him, and he is not giving us. So Radhika may die for this. She is so worried. She has left his food and taking water, everything. So it must come to us, so that we can return to Srimati Radhika. Then Srimati Yashoda told that, oh, my daughters, you should wait a little.
Don't worry.
And he at once went to Krishna and
Madhumangal,
and they were playing with that, oh, you should repeat what you were telling and hearing and giving something to eat. In the end, Yashoda came at once and took the bird very
forcefully.
Snatched up. What you are doing? And took the ear of Krishna, twisting. Oh, Nand Baba is waiting for you to take Mahaprasadam, and you are here with birds and so
animals.
You want to be animal and birds? Oh, this should come. And he took the hands of Krishna, taking Krishna forcibly. And Madhumangal was telling, like seeing what is happening. At once he came and visited here, and he came in the room where the two girls were
sitting, waiting.
Waiting, and she came, oh, take it. And at once he should go to there. And they returned. So you can think that how and who was this Shuk? But how he became in the shape of a man, this parrot. You know that all the birds, all the serpents, all the animals, deers, everything of Krishna Lok are transcendental. All are transcendental. It has been written by Srila Raghunath Das Goswami, Jatkinchetrin Gulmaki Katamukham Goste Samastang Hitat Sarvananda Mukunda Daitang Lilan Kulam Param Sastre Muhur Muhur Nishtankitang Jancha Brahma Deir Pishaspihan Tato Sarvam Mayaidam Bandate. Raghunath Das Goswami is doing bandana to all creepers, all trees, all the animals, even to a scorpion, even to snakes and all. Why? Oh, you are all associate, transcendental associate of Krishna. You can give Krishna bliss and Krishna bhakti, pure bhakti. So I am praying to you all. How a snake serves Srimati Radhika and Krishna conjugal. Once Srimati Radhika was in anger, And he was ready to go from Krishna to his Radha Kunda from anywhere in Govardhan. And he was quickly going, returning. And Krishna was so much worried for that. He wanted to stop Radhika, not to going. But she was very strongly in mood to not to be with Krishna. So when she was going, two, three, four steps, he saw that there was a very poisonous snake. And when he saw Srimati Radhika, from other side he did,
raising his horse and hissing.
Oh, Srimati Radhika was so much afraid. And telling, oh Krishna, Krishna. And he ran and he
embraced.
No, he fell in the lap of Krishna. Krishna was fell. He could not do. But this serpent made Srimati Radhika to again meet with. So linanukuram, so helpful for all these things. To if snakes and scorpions and all others are helping in Krishna and Radhika serving anyhow. To what we speak others? So all are transcendental in Vrindavan. We should have eyes to see this. So Sukadeva Goswami was Sukh parrot of Srimati Radhika. When Krishna pastimes were what? Samapta ho gai.
Ended.
Completed.
And he began to return to Golok Vrindavan with his all associates. Then Srimati and Radhika told, ordered this parrot that you should be in world. World needs you. Because when we will return to Golok Vrindavan, there will be none to save this world by Hari Katha. So you should be in this world and to save this world by Hari Katha. He began to weep. Very, bahut jor se rone lage.
Bitterly
weep. How I can be without you, conjugal? I cannot be in this world. But they told that we will empower you to be here and to speak Harikatha everywhere in this world. And after your work will be finished, you can come there, no harm. So they returned to Golok Vrindavan and parrot was here. He was flying here and there, looking that where Harikatha is going on. Without Harikatha he cannot be. So if there anywhere he was searching the places, he went in Kailash. And where Shankar was telling this Harikatha, Bhagavat Katha, how Krishna came to this world. And he was explaining to his wife, Parvati Devi. From beginning she was hearing. And there on a branch of a tree, hiding himself, this parrot was there hearing Harikatha. When in Srimad Bhagavat in third canto, he was explaining how creation was done, how all kinds of things were made, and other things. No interest, she being a lady devotee, she slept. But that parrot was very careful. He began to do, What more, very good, go on. Like in the voice like Parvati. And Shankar saw that, Parvati is hearing everything and he went on. But when 10th canto was
completed,
when again 11th and 12th came, she walked. and told, I was sleeping. I could not hear all these things. I want that. I request you to tell again. Then Shankar told that, I told all these things in vain. I saw that you are doing go on. Very good, very good. Who was doing so? I have not heard all these things. So he began to look that who has such that who was doing like this? Like Parvati's voice. And he saw that in the branch of a very green tree, a reddish leaf, and there was a very good pear, very beautiful pear. He took his trident, and began to follow. I will kill this bird. Because being a
unqualified
person, and he heard, in Gita, or in Srimad Bhagavat, Krishna has told to Arjuna in Gita that you should not tell this Srimad Bhagavat Gita to any unqualified person. If you are telling, then you will have felt so much offenses. So you should not. It will go without any fruit. So if you are telling all these things to any unqualified person, those who have no honor, you should not tell. So Srimad Bhagavat should not be told. But he is like a bird, and he has heard, so I should kill. Otherwise he will be imitation guru, and then he will be making so many
problems,
offenses and problems, and he will cheat others. So he wanted to kill. But at once that bird flew away, and very nearer he came to
Badrikashram.
Though by air going, only 4 or 5 miles. But now,
by bus
or
any vehicle,
in vehicle or by on foot, it will take 1 month going there, so long distance. So in a moment he flew, and Shankar took his trident and began to follow. He was not so much a durbal vyakti,
an ordinary person.
He also walked in a sky, and he began to flew, and he followed. And in the meantime, that parrot came in the ashram cottage of Vyasadeva, where Vyasadeva was explaining Srimad Bhagavat same to his wife,
Bhitika Devi.
And she was hearing all these things like very carefully. That it is like a nectar I am taking. So his mouth was some open. And at once that bird
entered in his room.
But there was no pain or anything. And he heard for 16 years or 12, some no harm, 12 years or
16.
I think that Bhagavat is divided in 12, so 12 years he heard. That Vyasadeva told him, who you are in the womb of your mother? Now your mother is feeling some pain. Then Shiva came, Shankar came and told, and searching there, Vyasadeva told, he did pranam to Shankar, and Shankar did pranam to Rishi Prakal. And then Vyasadeva told, what you are searching? Have you seen any parrot coming here? Yes, I have seen. But why you are searching? I want to kill that bird. Why? Because he has heard Srimad Bhagavatam being unqualified. So I want to kill. Then Vyasadeva began to laugh.
What is the result of
that? You know what is the result of hearing Srimad Bhagavatam? Yes, I know. What? He becomes ajar amar.
Immortal.
Immortal. Then if he has become immortal, how you can kill him, kill that bird? You cannot kill. And he began to laugh. Then Shankar realized his
mistake.
And then he also began to
laugh.
And then he returned. Oh, Krishna has arranged anything. So, nothing to do. After that, after 12 years, Vyasadeva requested that, who are you in the womb of your mother? How you are giving pain? You should come out of womb. The boy in womb told, I am Sukh, but I cannot come. I can come in this same moment when any powerful person will
take away
this maya from this world. And that moment I can come. He told them, I am powerful, I can do like this. I am taking whole maya here. You should just come out. He told that, I have no faith. If Krishna will come and tell that, then I can come. At once Vyasadeva remembered Krishna, and Krishna came there. Then Krishna told, oh parrot, you should come down from your mother. Om. He told them, who are you? I am Krishna. Oh, my namaskar to you. What do you want? You should come out. He told that, I can come only when you will take this maya from this world. What is this maya? Maya. There are two letters in this word. Ma means no. Ya means what you are realizing in this world. What you are thinking that I am this body, you are not this body. You are thinking that they are your father, mother, sister and all other things. And all belongs to you, wealth and animals and all the things. But your attachment with them, it is a wrong thing. So maya, don't believe in this. So by the illusory power of whose maya is going on like this, that I am this body, these are minds, this is called maya. One fraction,
manifestation
of yogamaya. This is mahamaya. So if you will take mahamaya, then I will come. He told, yes, you can come very quickly. I am giving time. That in a very short short, if some linseed seeds are given and they cannot be there for
even a fraction of a second.
I am giving time, and so you should come out. So Krishna did that. He at once came and began to run. And Sukadeva Goswami, Vyasadeva, he is out of maya. He is transcendental. He is really qualified to hear Srimad Bhagavat that I have seen in my trance. So I want that this voice should study Srimad Bhagavatam with me. And then he should
preach
everywhere in this world Bhagavat Katha. By which all the by which whole world can be liberated. And they will have bhakti, and thus Srimad Bhagavat will be preached in the whole world. Then that thinking this, oh my son, he was falling. We should do one kirtan.
Devanath will say, Mina Janma or stay Janma de lo kirtan kulla hai.
Devanath
Prabhu is telling that birthday of his wife, she can.
Today, birthday of his wife, appearance day.
So she can do any kirtan.
Sing Hindi song.
She should, you should pay something to.
Make a big feast.
Yeah.
Big feast. Gold Premiananda!
Very good day. And if you are not doing, then I will see that you have not married her.
Any day
we will. In Bejar we will take.
Anywhere.
Achha, you should sing one.
There are more.
Where?
Tomorrow.
Yes.
No.
Tomorrow.
Where?
Bejar.
Oh, where is she?
Right here.
Oh, you should sing a kirtan.
Hindi song.
We will give so much.
Oh, blessings.
Blessings and everything. You are joking, nothing to be.
He just wanted to do it.
He must just
give. Well, leave some sweets. Lit.
No, he's ready to do festival.
No. Huh? Very soon.
बंसी बजावत भयो
very in long process. Radhe, kya? Bansi bajavat bhayo kahune ghan shyam dekho, kahune ghan shyam dekho. Bansi bajavat bhayo kahune ghan shyam dekho.
राधे तेरो श्याम हमने बंजार में देखो, राधे तेरो श्याम हमने नंदगांव में देखो,
साल कट जाता है। माखन चूरावत भयो काहुने मेरो श्याम देखो, सी बजावत भयो काहुने घन श्याम देखो,
सी बजावत भयो काहुने मेरो श्याम तेरो शाम सजावत भयो काम में धन श्याम के राधे तेरो श्याम वृंदावन में देखो राधे तेरो श्याम वृंदावन में
कट नहीं जाए, ताल कट जाता है थोड़ा सा और बाकी बहुत सुंदर है. वेरी गुड. यू शुड लर्न दैट ये कभी राग टूट नहीं जाए, बेताल ना हो जाए और सब ठीक है. बहुत सुंदर. इसको फिर से कल से अभ्यास करना, एक जगह दूसरी जगह गाना. एक तो फिनिश कर दी, दो मिनट है. देन व्यास वॉज फॉलोइंग. वाई नॉट ही वॉज अटैच टू हिज सन? Because he wanted to initiate that boy, and to through him he wanted to preach Srimad Bhagavatam. Srimad Bhagavatam is so high class of thing. It is the essence of whole Ved, Upanishad, Puran, Shastra, Mahabharata, Ramayana, and everything, which is in Bhagavat is. Not in anywhere, and anywhere it is anything, it is must be in Srimad Bhagavatam. Nigam kalpataror galitang phalam sukhamukha damrit darvasanyutam pivat bhagavatam rasamalayam muhur pabhuvibhav. We will explain it afterward, but I am going to. So Srimad Bhagavat is like essence of whole Srimad, Ved and Upanishad. Gita is only essence of Upanishads. Sarva Upanishado Gau. That all the Upanishads are like cow, and milk is Srimad Bhagavat, Gita. And Krishna is milkman. And calf is Arjun. And it is not only Arjun for whole world, that milk. But Srimad Bhagavat is essence of all the Vedas, including Mahabharata, Gita, and Gita is not Rasa, but Srimad Bhagavat is Rasa. Nigam kalpator galitang rasam. Vedas are like tree. The Rasa is there, but we cannot taste. If you are choosing, okay?
Sucking.
Okay. The root of trees of mango. You are sucking branches. You are sucking flowers. You cannot have that. If you are taking fruits of mangoes, green, matured, rust will not come. When you will ripen, and any parrot will smell and touch. Give his touch by his mouth, or not, or it should be ripened so much. Then itself coming from its branch, even in touch of air or without, when it will ripe, it will come. Then it will be so sweet, and we can taste. So we cannot take it, this rush from the trees like Kalpavriksha, Vedas, Upanishadas, Puran, even to Gita, that rush will not come. When it will come in the shape of Srimad Bhagavatam, and especially by the mouth of Sukadeva Goswami, who was he? He was associates of Radhika and Krishna. So it will be more sweeter. So Sukadeva Goswami, he thought that Sukadeva Goswami is so qualified person in this whole world. I should make him study Srimad Bhagavatam. He should hear. I am not searching anyone in this world who is qualified to study Srimad Bhagavatam. So he was doing like, ocean, ocean. But trees were. when he went some
distance,
some very beautiful Gandharvas, wives of Gandharva, they were playing in the water, any pond, good pond. So many lotus were there, so fragrant air was blowing. And they were naked and they were playing to each other, bring water like this. And in the meantime, Sukadeva Goswami passed. They never looked after him. They were playing. But when Vyasadeva, being aged so much, 200 years, 300, become some old, so much white beard and long hairs, with also white, and he was falling. Then they became some ashamed. They came out of pond, they took their garments, and they, on the hidden in any tree, say, and they were doing pranam to Vyasadeva. Vyasadeva came nearer to them and asked, my dear daughters,
great granddaughters,
why you assembled with me? I am so much old, and my son, his age is like 12, he is naked, and he is going, you have no assembled for her, and now, why you are assembling? You can come in my laps, like father and mother, more than that, and you are ashamed with me. They told that your son, being at the age of 12, he was nothing to ask with us, that who are you? You are wood or stone or anything. And he was in trance like that, and he was going. And you saw that we are girls, and you are coming to me and asking why. So you have sensed that we are ladies and you are male and we are female. So you have some. What is shame? He doesn't, never knows that. What is shame? Like this cloth, his body is there. Nothing to
cover.
This body is also like
cover.
What is the use of cover to cover? So he is going, and we have no shame. But now, looking you, oh, you are saying that you were naked, and after that you became covered, your this body. That is why. But Sukadeva Goswami went to a very deep forest, like birds there. Wanted to sing. So he took one poem of Srimad Bhagavatam and gave it to the hunters that you should go, and this is a very powerful mantra. If you will chant this mantra in forest, all kinds of birds and what you want, all will be collected very easily. So you should go. And he went, and they began to shout this mantra. Varaha Pidam Natavarbapu Karnayo Karnikaram Bibhradvasa Kanak Kapisham Vaijayanti Shamanam Randrana Venu Radhar Sudhaya Puriyan Gopabindai Vrindaranyam Sabadaravanam Pravishat Gita Kirto. This is the best sloka for the beauty of Krishna. Krishna is going with lakhs and lakhs cows, with lakhs and lakhs cowherd boys like Dham, Sidham, Sudham, Vasudham, Stok, Krishna, Madhumangal, Shuval and all others, Arjun, Ujjwal, playing them with them and shouting sometimes cows like Dhiri, Dhiri, means
slowly, slowly,
slowly, slowly, they become dhiri. Not running here. Tiri, Tiri, oh, you want to take water? Tiri, 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 come on.
Down
the bank of this pond to Jamuna. Niri, Niri, means, oh, you should take water.
Pani.
Choo, choo. Choo, choo, choo,
choo. Now drink.
And drinking, like this. Playing with the boys. All boys are clapping sometimes and dancing with Krishna. They are going one forest to another forest. Krishna, these claws are like very lightning.
Thunderbolt.
Thunderbolt. And his body is like Megha-shyam. Megha-shyam means?
Like a dark
new cloud.
New cloud. Not black. So much beautiful. Krishna is most beautiful. Not black. But love. And new clouds taking full of so much water there. As if water is going to
rain.
Sorry. And Vanmala is there. Vanmala means?
Five kinds of flowers.
Five or seven kinds of white flowers. And some Tulsi Manjari is there. And we are hammering on these.
Humming.
And all the boys are Kanaiya, Kanaiya,
Kanaiya,
Jai Kanaiya Lal Ki, doing this. And thus Krishna is going. And some fruit friends are there. And in fruit friends are, there are 19 kinds of symptoms.
Symbols.
Vajra, Dhaja, Ankush,
Pataka,
and so. Everything is there. So he is doing pranam to this. Also Brahma is doing Nomidhate Abrapapuse Taridambaraya Gunjavatansa Paripachal Sanmukhaya. Sanmukhaya
Kalapeta
Vetra Vishana Venu Lakshmasriye Midupade Pasupangajaya. So many, but this sloka is most powerful. Hearing this, he came at once. From where you learnt this sloka? Oh, my Gurudev has
taught.
And so many birds came in their
nest.
Then they became so happy, and he told that, I want to meet your Gurudev, but what is the quality? This is the shape of
beauty
of Krishna. But how merciful he is, I want to know. Then went to Vyasadeva and were very happy that so many birds has come in their net. And they told that a very beautiful boy came to us naked, and he told that if that Krishna is so beautiful, what are his qualities? Then he told that you should read this shloka, and so many birds again will come. Then he told, Aho Bakiyam Stanakalakutam Jighansaya Gayataya Pyasadvi Lebhe Gating Tato Dhatri Achyuta Kangva Dayalum Saranam Brajema Kangva Dayalum Saranam Brajema. Oh, you want to hear? So you should repeat this in the
forest.
That Aho Baki Stanakalakutam, Aho Baki, the sister of Bakasu, that is Putana, he took so much
strong poison.
Strong poison is her breast. And came in the shape of very darling mother, and he wanted to kill Krishna. He took at once Krishna in his or her lap and gave breast forcibly in the mouth of Krishna. And Krishna sought that poison with her
life.
And he left his body and she would die. But Krishna was so merciful that he made her atma so pure, soul so pure, and he gave the same
position
like mother. And she at once went to Golok Vrindavan, Golok, and there she became eternal like mother, Dhatri Gati. Dhatri means sometimes giving bread, milk to Krishna. So Krishna is how merciful. So in this world, those who have some intelligence, they should surely do bhajan of Krishna. Those who are not serving and having no devotional service to Krishna, actually they are like a donkey without any horn, and their tail is also
cut.
Cutting.
tailless.
Tailless and hornless.
Two legs.
Especially that two legs has been cutting down. So these all are like donkeys, those who are not serving, uttering the name of Krishna, singing and hearing. Then he heard at once he came. And he came to Vyasadeva, told, I want to read, study whole Srimad Bhagavatam. And he studied there. And now he is praying to Vyasadeva, I was in the way of Nirvishesh Brahma. Nirgunya api parinishthitah. I have so much fixed my intelligence in Nirvishesh Brahma. But this Nirvishesh Brahma is different from Shankar Brahma.
Shankar Sampradaya.
Shankar Sampradaya. That Shankar Sampradaya are offender, but he was not offender. His Brahma was Nirvishesh, no akar, no shape, but so much qualities. His Brahma is so merciful, but Shankar, nothing. Having no shape, no attribute, no power, nothing. Like zero of Bauddha. So much difference. And he began to study, and after that, he became so learned and so sweet, knowing all the rasas. And then he came in the council of Parikshit Maharaj, and he was uttering Srimad Bhagavatam. Gaur Pramanandi. Kirtan. Yes, Pancha Tattva and then Mama.
Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shumashari Gaur Bhakta Krishna Chaitanya,
I can't tell you've been great food from that.